I am currently on prep for a bodybuilding show. I was a competitive runner for about 8 years, and then I discovered powerlifting, which is a strength sport. I was a competitive powerlifter for like 9 years. I did it all through high school. I did it all through college. I was captain of the powerlifting team in college, and then competed as an individual for a number of years while I was active duty. About 2 years ago, I decided to transition from powerlifting to bodybuilding. Powerlifting is nothing about what you look like and all about strength. It's the biggest bench plus biggest squat plus biggest deadlift combined for a total, biggest total per weight class wins, right? Nothing aesthetic, doesn't matter what you look like, it's all performance based, all about strength. Bodybuilding, arguably, is the complete opposite. It has nothing to do with performance, it has nothing to do with strength, but it's all about aesthetics and how you look. Bodybuilding's that sport where people, you know, build muscle, then they burn fat, and then they put on the little tiny underwear, banana hammock things, depending on what category you're in, and you tan up, and you get on stage, you flex your muscles, and it's all about aesthetics, right? I will admit, bodybuilding is kind of a niche interest, right? Like, I think everybody at some point in their life has and been interested in their own health and fitness. Probably at some point in your life, you're like, hey, you know, maybe I could benefit from adding a few extra pounds of muscle to my frame or burning a little bit of body fat. But bodybuilding is all about taking things to the extreme. So yes, I am on prep for a show right now. This is my third show in 2 years. I'm still very much an amateur in the sport of bodybuilding. I've learned a lot, but I also know that I have a long way to go if I ever want to have a super competitive physique. I say all that to explain that I am running on fumes. Actually, whatever is past fumes. I think everyone knows what it's like to be hungry for a couple of hours or maybe even a couple of days, but to be in a severe caloric deficit for 3 to 4 months is a weird feeling that not many people will ever experience. And honestly, I don't ever recommend that you experience it, because some really, really weird things happen when you've been hungry for an extended amount of time. You know, our bodies thrive on carbohydrates, right? That's our primary source of fuel. Your body builds up a thing called glycogen, which is what it does with those carbohydrates. It stores up glycogen, and that's where your body pulls from whenever it needs energy to perform daily tasks. Whether it's like exercising or not, you need energy, you need glycogen in order to perform anything physically. Also, your brain runs on glycogen. And so when you are in a severe caloric deficit and you don't have glycogen present, brain don't be working so good. It just doesn't. And it's kind of funny, but it's kind of not, because it definitely has like a significant impact on your ability to do daily tasks, to work, to be present, to maintain relationships. It's kind of weird. But I do love bodybuilding from like a scientific standpoint. It's all about numbers. It's all about input and output and measurements. And it requires an absurd amount of discipline, but at the same time, I think I love it, even though I'm like in the midst of suffering right now. So anyway, I say all that to say, if I stumble over my words, or if it seems like I'm not really formulating full sentences or full thoughts, please excuse me. It's just because my brain has no energy. There's nothing left. Whatever running on past fumes is what I'm running on right now. But anyway, let's get this thing started. So this is supply drop number 27. As always, I'm gonna be showing you the major bucks. There are 4 tiers to join our community. There are 3 month-to-month options. Those are lieutenant, the captain, and the major. And then we have 1 big boy option. It's a quarterly option that comes to your doorstep 4 times a year, and that one's called the general. That one's gonna be the most bang for your buck. It's gonna be the most tactical gear cram packed into one box, but all the options are great, great echelons. There's gonna be some valuable stuff in all of those boxes. Today I'm gonna be showing you the major, and I'm excited to show you what's in store. Let's get started. So as always, we include these booklets. Sometimes we call them monthly cards. I handwrite these descriptions of these products. Read it if you want to, don't read it if you don't want to. But essentially, I think it's important for you to know all of the details associated with the products that are in your box. Sometimes they're obvious, sometimes they're not. Sometimes there's information in here that may help you to see these products or to utilize them in a different way. So read it if you want to, don't read it if you don't want to. I understand either way. So we're actually gonna start off with something that has been keeping me alive the past few months, and that is ground coffee. Brought to you by the red-blooded Americans at Cash Coffee. This sweet but strong medium roast espresso grind is roasted and bagged in Paradise, Utah. Owned by Jamie Butters, this small coffee shop has gone to huge lengths to provide for US veterans and first responders. Though Jamie himself is not a veteran, he has lost multiple friends who were veterans to suicide. Jamie has made it his mission to save lives and provide care to those who struggle with mental health. Jamie's coffee shop is not only a place to grab some caffeine and a bite to eat, but it serves as a place where people can come to disconnect from the outside world and talk with those who are going through similar situations. Furthermore, Jamie has founded a 501c3 called the Community Family Coalition, with the purpose of providing a support network to people who need professional guidance and resources. Look, it's not the most interesting bag of coffee in the world. It's just a white bag with a sticker on it. They have multiple blends. We do love this one called the Cash K9. It's got some cool artwork there on the front of the bag. But what's important about this coffee is the story behind it. So I did actually call up Jamie, the owner of the coffee shop, and say, hey man, like, I just wanna make sure I tell your story accurately. What can I say about you and your coffee in order to best represent you, since we decided to include them in our Crate Club crate? And he said, don't worry about me. It's not about my story. It's about the veterans who come to my coffee shop. He was one of the most like down to earth guys I've spoken to in a long time. And he said, all I want you to do is help to funnel some traffic to my 501c3 and ask people to donate in order to support a good cause. Right here in our booklet, we actually do have the website to his nonprofit. So if you ever, if you feel like you have the time and the money and the resources to go to his website, do a little bit of reading and contribute, I know it would mean a world to him, and you really could make the difference in someone's life. The more you read about it, there's actually multiple articles and news sources who have spoken about this guy and what he's doing out there in Paradise, Utah. It's a really cool story. I mean, coffee is one of those things that just brings people together. It doesn't really matter who you are or where you're from. I think we've all had a hot cup of Joe at some time in our life. And sometimes that hot cup of Joe can mean a lot to some people, you know? Unfortunately, it's true that American veterans do suffer with a lot of mental anxieties. Some people are ridden with PTSD. You don't have to necessarily be a war-torn veteran in order to experience stress and anxiety. It's just a tough life to live, and a lot of people struggle when they leave their time in service. So I think it's really cool that people like Jamie exist who have gone so far out of his way to create an environment where veterans can come together, have a cup of coffee, support one another, and if they really need it, there are professional resources, medical resources available to those people to help them get through those dark times. So I hope you enjoy this bag of coffee. At the end of the day, it's just good coffee. Whether you support the mission or not, it is a good cup of coffee. But at the same time, I do hope you take the chance to get to read about Jamie, read about his organization, and if you see it in your heart to do so, go donate. Thanks. Moving on. Headlamps are a must. You really can't put a price on hands-free visibility, especially in low-light, high-stress situations. Whether you're a military member, a first responder, a blue-collar worker, hunter, camping enthusiast, or just a person who hates to hold a flashlight in their mouth when the lights go off, a quality headlamp is essential. Featuring four different light settings, a single-click button, and IPX4 materials, the Cyclops Poseidon is a fantastic option. With the brightest setting offering stunning 2,000 lumens and up to 200 meters of reach, this headlamp can easily light up your home, the forest, a road, a campsite, and more. The Poseidon also offers a magnet that can be used to conveniently store a headlamp while not in use or as a method of casting light without being bound to the user's head. The Poseidon also features a strobing effect for emergency situations and offers an adjustable head strap that will comfortably fit any head, with or without a helmet. Seriously though, I think headlamps are an essential. I feel like before I got into like headlamp world as a user myself, I think I thought it was gonna be like, it's you think it's like a tactical item, it's like a hardcore, like you've gotta be a camping specialist or a first responder in order to like own one of these things, but that's not true at all. It's so convenient to have light strapped to your head when you need it most. I live in coastal Georgia, you know, unfortunately tornadoes and harsh hurricanes and storm surges happen quite frequently. So we lose power a lot, and the first thing I do is go grab a headlamp, stick it on my head, and I just continue about my day. It is so nice to be able to see what you're doing in the dark, hands-free. So this product from Poseidon is a great option. Fits right on your head. I'm wearing a hat right now, which obviously shows that it's no problem whatsoever. The elastic here is super durable, super comfortable, super stretchy. You could wrap it around like a protective helmet. You could wrap it around your ACH if you're active duty. There's options here. You actually don't have to even use the center strap. That one's removable altogether if you don't like it. This is a great product because again, it's just one button here on the side and immediately you have access to light. There are three different light settings. The brightest one is 2,000 lumens, which is pretty dang bright. And if you double click, you've got a strobing effect that would be reserved for usually like an emergency situation, trying to draw attention to yourself. And then last but not least, you have a magnet on this side, which you can then use to just stick it to your refrigerator or any sort of metalized surface that you have nearby. And again, it's hands-free light, and you really just can't beat that. It's also adjustable, so you can move it up and down. You know, one of the things with headlamps is like, and I've made this mistake a million times, if you're like out in the field, you're wearing a headlamp because you want to see what's in front of you, but then you need to talk to your buddy and then you look directly at him and you're blasting him in the face with a headlamp. That's not a pleasant experience. So you can just turn it down so that the light is actually being cast onto your face, onto your hands, or what's happening in front of you, and you're not blinding the person in front of you. But when you want to go back to Cyclops mode, you just shift it right back up and you're good to go. These things are so convenient. I own multiple. I like this one a lot. I think everyone should have one readily accessible, and the next time the power goes out in your house, I think you're gonna be grateful that you have this on hand. What else we got? Clean, lubricate, and protect. These are the non-negotiables and what makes a good CLP. Breakthrough Clean Technologies Biosynthetic All-in-One CLP is an expertly crafted product that uses the finest base oils, additives, and the most effective solvents that modern chemistry has to offer. This CLP removes carbon buildup, lead deposits, oil, and grime, while penetrating deep to provide protection from rust and corrosion, all while minimizing friction and wear from metal-to-metal contact. While intended for use on firearms, CLP can also be used on tools, vehicles, locks, knives, bicycles, and any other metal surface that is subject to corrosion. CLP, man, see, clean, lubricate, and protect. I know that there are some purists out there that they want one product for cleaning, one product for lubrication, and then one product for protection. I don't disagree with that mentality. Like, if you want to have three different products just for like the ultimate package there, I get it. But CLP does a really, really good job at attacking all three of those tasks at the same time. When I was active duty, like, CLP was a must have. Everyone had it. There was no other alternative. If your weapon was dirty, hit it with CLP. If you're experiencing malfunctions, hit it with CLP. If you're about to turn it back into the arms room, hit it with CLP. This was like the end-all be-all solution, and I'm glad that we were able to send this out. This should be in everybody's range bag. Again, you don't have to use it on weapons. Technically, you could use it on knives or any other metalized surface, but this is a great, great option to have in your range bag. I definitely think everybody should at least give it a chance. I don't think you're gonna be disappointed. This is actually a made in the USA product. Of course, we always try to promote American-made products whenever we get the chance to do so, so it's really cool that we were able to feature this breakthrough clean technology product. CLP, baby. Clean, lubricate, and protect. Non-negotiable. Make sure you have it with you. Next, I'm going to show you a what was almost a controversial item in our little crate club circles. This thing's called the Buddy Pouch. Meet the Buddy Pouch, the multi-purpose pouch that can connect to any waistband via patented magnetic technology. No belt required. The Buddy Pouch can be affixed to any waistband, making it a super convenient option for anyone in need of a little extra space for keys, cards, cash, and more. Many forms of athletic wear do not feature pockets, and the ones that do are often small and unusable. The Buddy Pouch is a solution to that problem. It's comfortable, discreet, and water-resistant. Whether you're a runner, walker, cyclist, traveler, or just someone who needs an extra pocket, the Buddy Pouch is the perfect option. I've talked about this. We have a whole team of people that get together and review products. I'm not the only guy. Like, we've got some experts, survivalists, former military, the whole nine yards. And we get together and review products before making a final decision on whether or not it's gonna make it into the box. This was not an immediate yes for some people, but for me it was, and so I'm super stoked that we were able to include it. Buddy Pouch is a little bit of a silly name, but it's awesome. So check this out. Yes, it's just a pouch. Velcro on the front. You have two pockets on the inside. The front one is protected by mesh, and the one on the inside is sort of insulated on both sides. It has a zipper here for additional access to that same pocket. And then on the back side, you have these magnetic clips and a super soft material, which is going to hook onto your waistband. I wore Silkies just for this unboxing to demonstrate what I'm talking about. So I think everyone might know what I'm talking about. The Silkies are like the little shorty shorts that got super popular by, God, I don't know who popularized these. Some people call them Ranger panties. Some people call them Silkies or short shorts. Somewhere along the way, I think someone in the military popularized these things, and they're my go-to shorts. I wear them on leg day. I wear them around the house. I wear them for running. I think they're the greatest shorts to exist because they're so small. They're so light and they feel like they're not there. And I know that sounds kind of weird, but I hate to have extra material on my legs while I'm trying to train legs, especially while running. If you want to go for an 8, 10, 15 mile run with a long pair of shorts, good luck, buddy, because that extra material is going to cause some problems in the long run. So that's why I wear short shorts. But the biggest drawback is that they don't have pockets. There's just not enough room. They're not deep enough to even have pockets. They usually have one of these things installed. You know what I'm talking about. It's like enough room for, like, not a credit card, but maybe like one house key, one car key, but it's not comfortable and it's not secure because it doesn't zip in any way. It's just kind of there and it folds up. In comes the Buddy Pouch. So what this thing can be is an extra pocket for all of the things that you need to carry with you to the gym or to the grocery store or on a run, right? So all you do is stick it down your pants. I'm trying to do this without exposing too much, because I know you people of the internet get kind of weird. Stick the fabric-y side down your pants, fold it forward, and now you've got a Buddy Pouch fully installed. So then I have access to whatever I want to stick in here. Again, you've got two layers of pockets on this side, sealed with Velcro. You've got a zipper on the side here. If you're one of those old school guys that's still using like the wired headphones, no judgment, but you can stick your phone in and then feed the wired headphones out and into your head. I love this thing. It is so convenient, it is so comfortable, and it makes so much sense to me. Because look, like I said, I'm a big Silkies guy, but Silkies don't have pockets. These are my old active duty shorts. See there, it says Army. But guess what? No pockets. It is what it is, man. Pockets are not essential for athletic performance. It really is like just additional material, and I recognize that. But God, it's inconvenient to have to show up to work in pockets that don't, or in shorts that don't have pockets. You gotta put your wallet somewhere. You gotta have cash, you gotta have your driver's license, you gotta have keys to your house, you gotta have your cat card when you're going on post. You just have to have stuff. It's the world we live in. And not having pockets can be a huge inconvenience, but in comes the buddy pouch. You can't tell that I'm wearing it at all right now. This thing is awesome, and it's so comfortable. This material, I don't know what this is made of, but it's extremely soft and it's extremely low friction. It's actually like zero friction. So when if it's sitting on your skin, it's super comfortable. It's not gonna cause any irritation. In fact, I used this yesterday, day before yesterday. Went to the gym, wearing my Silkies, needed to go to the grocery store afterwards, and instead of having to carry my wallet and my phone and my gym key and my car key in my hands, I just had my buddy pouch. So I was able to train with my normal shorts that I love so much. Before I went to the grocery store, I had this in my car, already loaded up with my phone, keys, wallet, blah, blah, blah. Stuck it in, went and did my grocery shopping, paid for my groceries, and I went on home. It's so convenient, and I love it. I hope you love it as much as I do. But it's just a simple solution to a problem that we're all facing, and I think no one was doing anything about it. So shout out to Buddy Pouch. The Voyager by Cold Steel was designed to be the true everyman knife. Lightweight, comfortable, and super sharp, this knife is rugged, dependable, and perfect for hunting and camping, as well as general utility. The Voyager excels in many survival and rescue applications and has proven itself to be very popular with police and military personnel. Each knife in the Voyager series is precision engineered and held to Cold Steel's highest exacting standards. This product features a Japanese steel alloy blade and a triad locking mechanism, which is arguably the most secure, safe, and shock-resistant lock on the market today. The Voyager also features ergonomic Grivex handles, which are reinforced with heat-treated 6061 aluminum liners. So they do send you an additional clip if you want to have your clip stored on the other side, if you're left-handed versus right-handed, or you just have some sort of preference. Quality knife companies always give you an extra clip, and I love that. Check this bad boy out. This is not a small blade. Look at this bad boy. Woo! Let's see if I can one-hand this. Hell yeah, brother. It's not easy to one-hand. It's not assisted opening, so you gotta get that whole thing out there yourself. Give a little bit of, a little flick of the wrist, and it comes out just fine. This is a nice knife. If there was such a thing, look at the shape of this blade. Very reminiscent of like combat knives or a Bowie knife. If there's such a thing as a folding Bowie knife, that's exactly what this thing would be. I love this. It's actually quite lightweight considering the size of the blade. The blade itself has got this great finish to it. I love everything they've done about this. I think this is G10 handles. It's super, super grippy. Feels great in your hand. They describe it as an ergonomic grip. A lot of people like to say that. This one is truly ergonomic. You could use this as an EDC, like an everyday carry. This Civivi knife is what I've been carrying with me most often. It's not even like a high-end blade, but I really do love the shape and size of it. I think size is probably one of the most important factors for me when I consider an EDC. If it's gonna be in my pocket all day long, I just want it to be comfortable, depending on, you know, what kind of day I'm about to have. Do I plan to use a knife or do I not? If I'm not planning to use one, I just wanna have something that's comfortable. But I pull this out just to kind of show you the size comparison. This Voyager is not a small blade. That is a behemoth. You can EDC this thing if you want, but I would definitely plan to have like loose clothing or deep pockets. This is gonna be a great hunting knife. This is a workhorse knife. I think if you're gonna put this in your pocket, you plan to be cutting something up that day, which is great, put it to use. This is exactly what it was made for, and I know Cold Steel will not let you down. Great product, great knife. Excited to add this to my collection and put it to use. Yeah, that's a nice blade. Moving on. Two more products to show you, very excited about both of them. Any firearms enthusiast will agree that having options is important. Options for storing magazines is a part of that mentality. The GPS Tactical Universal Magazine Holder can hold up to 3 magazines, keeping your equipment protected and organized. Featuring a magnetic backing, this magazine organizer is a great option for a gun safe inside a vehicle alongside a toolbox, metal cabinets, or anywhere you see fit. The ability to get your magazines off the shelf or out of your range bag helps to free up space and keep your materials organized. Anywhere you can find or install a metallic surface, you can stick the GPS Tactical Universal Magazine Holder. Very simple product, but very useful. So you've got magnets on the inside here, and you can just stick this thing to any, I've said metallized surface like 4 times today already in this conversation. I'm kind of tired of that. Any metal surface, metallized surface, metallic surface, magnetic surface. Those are all synonyms. Falling apart. I'm falling apart. There's magnets in the back of this thing. You can use it to stick to stuff that magnets stick to, right? You can hold up to 3 magazines. So we've talked about this before, anything that we send out in these Crate Club boxes. Just because it was designed to be used as a magazine holder doesn't mean that you have to use it as a magazine holder. If you want to store pens and staplers in here, like, have at it. Organization is organization. It's a part of being functional, it's a part of being prepared, is knowing where your things are and making sure that they're accessible when you need them most. I brought an ammo can, which is very full of ammo, just to show you that it is magnetic. Bingo bongo. You can stick this, you can stick it to the inside, you can stick it to the outside, you could stick this to the inside of a metal gun safe if you own one. Also, a lot of people like to have like loadouts in their vehicles. If you install a metal panel on the back of your car seat, or maybe the headrest, or maybe the inside of the console, this would be a great place to stick that so that you have your magazines accessible. I've also seen people stick these to like metal cabinets or toolboxes, because then you could store, you know, nails or wrenches, whatever it is. It's just organization, man. There's no reason to not have it, but if you end up using it for magazines, then it works perfect for that too. Good material. GPS is a trusted brand, and I think you'll be able to find a good spot for this. One more item. Your weapon deserves somewhere comfy to stay when not in use. This all-black Grey Ghost soft pistol case is the perfect place. Featuring an adjustable carrying strap, diamond pattern nylon, and endless configurations, this soft case is as good as they come. The inside flap of the case offers a zippered mesh pocket for loose items, cleaning supplies, or other materials. The interior is also lined with a Velcro-like material, allowing the user to configure the included mag pouch and securing straps in an infinite number of ways. When it comes to Grey Ghost, you can't go wrong. I've seen quite a few pistol cases out there. Some people prefer hard cases, soft cases. I mean, everyone's entitled to an opinion, but when it comes to like Grey Ghost, everything I've put my hands on from Grey Ghost, I'm a big fan of. Those guys just know what they're doing. They know their target audience. They know what the end user looks like and what their end user wants when it comes to quality products associated with the firearms world. So in comes this soft pistol case. I love it. It's aesthetic, but at the same time, it's discreet. It feels very high quality. It's got a carrying strap on the top that is adjustable, so you could tighten it or loosen it if needed. You've got zippers on the sides, and my Glock 19 is already stored in here. Yours will not come with a Glock 19, so don't get too excited. And this is what it looks like on the inside. Like we mentioned, you've got a storage pouch over here, which is mesh. You could put, you know, whatever you wanted to in here, whether it's cleaning supplies, whether it's safety instructions, whether it's what you want. You could put snacks in here, I don't care. But you have this as an accessible option. And then what's cool is this side, which is lined with Velcro, and you can configure it in whatever way that you want. So I actually have one magazine in here already, and then my Glock itself. So, I mean, you can pull this thing out however you want to, but I was just gonna show you how I installed the actual components. So, all of this comes out and it can be reconfigured however you want it to go. You don't have to use it all. You can throw whatever you want to in here, right? But it is kind of cool that they give you the option to stick this stuff in whichever way you want to. Kind of the way I went about it, because everyone's weapons are different shapes and sizes, is I started with securing this end of the weapon, getting that Velcro nice and tight, getting this end of the weapon, same. I felt like this was easier than installing the Velcro and then trying to make it fit the weapon. If you start with the Velcro on the weapon, you can then just stick it in here and it's already lined up perfectly. And then you can stick your magazines in there in whatever orientation makes most sense for you. So there it is. And I'm sure we all own additional Velcro things that could be used to store in here. Again, you don't have to use the pistol case as a pistol case, but this is where my Glock is gonna be resting when I don't wanna have it readily accessible. Granted, I normally have it readily accessible, But if you own multiple weapons, you're probably not carrying multiple weapons on a day-to-day basis. This is a good place to store your handgun when not in use. Love the zippers, love the color, love this diamond pattern that they feature on both sides. It's a great product. I love Grey Ghost, and they're gonna make sure that your stuff is taken care of when it's not being used. So that was supply drop number 27. We got through it together, even with my lack of brain power. I was talking to a coworker yesterday, and I was like, hey man, I am so sorry, but my brain is on like 4% right now. And that was yesterday. So right now we're on like 3.2% probably, max. But what I should be doing is brewing some coffee and getting some caffeine pumping through my system. So hopefully that'll help out a little bit. But that's the life that I've chosen. I thank you guys for being part of this community. If you made it this far in the video, I thank you for watching. This is something that we're passionate about. It's all about high quality products and preparedness and bringing people together who care about the same things. I've said it once and I'll say it a million times, iron sharpens iron. I'm very thankful to be part of this community. I'm thankful to interact with you people. I know there's a lot of capable and competent people out there that belong to this community, and I think that we're in the right spot. But my primary goal is to continue growing this community. I know that there's other people out there that would benefit from these products and benefit from the knowledge that we share with one another. So if you know anybody that wants to be part of the club, send them an invite. You can also gift them a box. You don't have to gift them the whole subscription, but you can do a one-time purchase and send them a box. I know they'll fall in love with it and they'll become a lifelong member, just like you and me. Hope everyone's doing well. I hope you enjoyed the video. Can't wait for supply drop number 28. We've got some good stuff coming. See you guys soon.